Hello, Mr. True here. Let's put continuous data into the TI-NSPIRE and show you how to do one-bar stats, which allow you to find min, max, Q1, Q3, median, standard deviation, all that good stuff that we care about with univariate quantitative data. So, we're going to open up a new document. We're going to add lists and spreadsheets. And we're going to come up here and click on the top of column A and call it data. Come down here and let's just put in some basic numbers like 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, and let's say 5, 7. Okay, so just a few numbers. Just 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, and 7. Let's add one more in here. Let's say 9. Okay, so with our data entered into list A, and it is easier if you put a name in here with the TI-NSPIRE, and don't use just one letter because then it'll ask you if you want to use a column variable or a variable. So data, and there we go. Now with that highlighted, or this cursor in this first column, let's hit menu, let's hit statistics, statistics calculations, and one variable statistics. Now, it'll say number of lists. Well, I just put the data in one list, so hit OK. And the X list, what would you like to use? Well, it defaults to list A, but again, we named it, so we're going to go select the down arrow, hit data, and I just put one column of numbers in with no, you know, I didn't put any kind of frequency list in, so that's going to default to 1, and where would you like your results at? Well, just another column, say column B, and hit OK. Voila, there we go. So we've got title, one bar stats. We've got the mean of those variables I just typed in, the sum of all of those numbers. And keep going down. We've got the S of X, the standard deviation of the sample, is 3.039. Sigma of X is the standard deviation of the entire population. We pretty much never use this out of the graphing calculator. We just always use S of X because this has a degree of freedom of n minus 1. And the standard deviation of the entire population doesn't have a degree of freedom because you supposedly used every element of the population. We had a sample size of 7. We have min is 1. Q1 is the value of 2. The median was also 2. Q3 is 7, and the max is 9. And then we've got another statistic here, which I'm not going to be concerned about. Now, let me come over here to column D and put data, I don't know, let's say data AA, just because I want to give it a different variable. Actually, I'm going to put in data F. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do here, and there's really no reason to do this unless the data in your book has been presented this way. I'm going to put a 1 in, enter. Now, you see here I put 3 2's. So I'm going to put a 2 in one time and go down. 3, and let me see what else numbers I had here. 3, 7, and 9. Okay, so 3, 7, and 9. Now each one of those data points only showed up once, except for the 2, which I put in 3 times. So I'm going to arrow over, and under E, I'm going to put FREQ for frequency. And as long as this doesn't become italicized, that is a variable name. It's an acceptable variable name. And I'm going to say, well, I had 1. The 1 showed up once. I put 2 in there 3 times. So I'm going to put in a frequency of 3. And there was, I put in 1, 3, 1, 7, and 1, 9. So maybe if you have a lot of data and the textbook has showed you, it's sort of cleaned that up by telling you how many 1's, how many 2's, how many 3's, and so on. That should be a 1. And so should that. So if you have been given data and it's been sort of like condensed and you were told how many times each piece of data came in or was presented, then that means you need a frequency column. This is not very common. It's very, very uncommon in the statistics books that I use. But let's see if we get the same mean of 3.7 and the same standard deviation of 3.04. So let's see if I can help you find one variable stats when you're given a frequency column. So I'm going to go to Data F. I'm going to hit Menu. I'm going to hit Statistics. Choose stat calculations and do one var stats again. We only have one list of data, so that's going to stay a 1. And we're going to find one var stats with data F. And now, the frequency list, I'm not going to leave that a 1 because I have a column of frequencies. Remember that 2 showed up 3 times. So I'm going to use, as a frequency list, I'm going to choose the column that I labeled frequency. And now when I hit OK, let's see what we get. One var stats. The mean was 3.71, and before it was 3.714, so that's the same. And S of X is 3.039. Well, that's the same as it was before. So, if you're given a list of raw data, and it's just a long list of numbers, then you can just type that data into a column and do one var stats. If you are given data that has been condensed and sort of simplified, see here I had typed in 2 3 times and here I've only typed in 2 once. So if you've been given data that's been sort of condensed and organized but then told how many times each piece of data shows up, you can make another column named frequency and then do one var stats. But instead of having the frequency set at 1, you're going to have the frequency set at whatever column, you know, whatever you've named that column with the frequencies in it. So, and don't forget, I couldn't do this until I opened up a new document. And then once I opened up a new document, I added a list and spreadsheet page. So there you go. That's how you do one var stats with the TI-NSPIRE, whether you're given one long list of numbers or a condensed list of numbers with a frequency column. You open up a document, you add a list and spreadsheet page, and you enter that data and do menu, statistics, stat calculations, and one var stats. So there you go. I hope that helps you find one variable statistics or calculate one variable statistics with a TI-NSPIRE. Thank you very much. I'm Mr. True. Go do your homework.